I think most of us are very anticipating advanced Santo. He looks cool, he has 3 points for attacking the basket, and double fade away. More importantly, he got clone jutsu. So today I'm going to calculate the cost for obtaining him. He can be obtained from the spin. Just like how we get the normal crystal. But with new spin page, we only can spin by using cash ticket in order to get honor crystal. How much per ticket? We can spend 270 cash coupon for 5 tickets. For 200 spins equal to 10,800 cash coupons. For current pricing is, let's say we buy at double vouchers event, we need to spend 100 USD and getting 4,935 cash coupons. Double vouchers equal to 9,870 cash coupons. Means about the cost for getting a 1 cento. Wow, it is not that bad. 100 USD for a character is considered okay.
Why you say so expensive, boy? Why you want to cheat on us? You no good.
My bad. I will reveal the truth later on. Is there any other method to obtain him? Yes. Stay tuned with me first. You will get the answer later. Let us continue to discuss his character first. We also need to know his ninjutsu. His attributes doesn't change much. His stats are still top. Let's go to his talent tree. First is flying on the ground. This will be his dancing moves. Basically, he has 3 crossovers. In order to summon his clone jutsu, he has to use his ulti within the combo. This is the mechanism for a 1 Santo. So the most complicated crossover moves is using 2 drives plus ulti plus 1 more drive then do a fadeaway or attacking the basket. Means 5 buttons or more to be pressed with correct timing. This require player skill and will have more combos to be unfolding. If I am the rival team, I will pick Maki as well in order to stop his dribble move. However, we are too naive. A 1 Centaur still can be dominating even without any crossover move. Let's see what is the skill next. Next is Flying Axe. This will consist 3 points of attack modes, dunks or layout or ulti layout. This talent make him godlike. Why I say so? This is 3 different poking timings. The tempo is like 1, 1.5 and 2. Means it incurs of guessing. For a defender, first is normal dunk, mean no guessing game. The second point is determined by whether he use his ulti or not. If he use his ulti is 1 blocking timing. If not using his ulti is another blocking timing. This make him got 3 blocking timings. Last move from this branch, he also has cash and dunk skill like Takasago dunks. This also can switch to layout as well. In he still can pose threat even he is not the ball handler. And most of his talents have anger break mechanism. We have to guess which one is real him and not to be confused by his clone. That will be the challenging part. Last is fake dunk then fade away. This will not that insane compared to other moves. This is because it's too close to the paint area, will get interfered too easily and need to waste another ulti. This is not a wise choice. So we hardly to see this fake dunk and fade away move in tournament matches. Next will be his pull out fade away, another core skill. We can take it as sidestep fade away. So long he wants to summon his clone, ulti must be used. First sidestep and second sidestep like Kokure. Additional third sidestep move is using ulti. The difference is, he can choose which points to fade away. First, second or third point. And more importantly, he can stop the shot. Not like Kokure. He still can drive to the basket even after the movement are done. Again, he has to sacrifice one of his ulti. The most insane part is double fade away. Just like Kuroko anime, Ayomine's signature move. Combine the second and the third talents, we need total 3 defenders to shut him down. That's why heavy interference character must be taken in order to defend his fade away. And the others to defend him around the basket. Next will be his blocking talents. First big talent note is still normal. The next one will be another ninjutsu. Flying Raijin Jutsu.
Are you kidding me? Are you sure this is a basketball game and not Ninja Wars?
This makes him super good in defense as well. Undisputable strong and unreal. Do not underestimate this branch too. This is the branch he can summon his clone without any cost of his ulti. So long he asks for the bobo, his clone can be generated. 0 chakra use. We can take it as catch and dunk skill. During dunking or fading away after the catch, he still can call his clone again. He can choose to dive, to dunk or to fade away. This talent has allowed him not to be scared of our King Maki. So long he is not driving, Maki ulti still will not affect him at all. So a heavy interference characters are his only counter for only his fade away part. We still need to rely on 2 strong pokers to guard his dunks and layout. So eventually it's a team effort in order to stop him. But no worry, still got long way to go. At least 8 months time before he appears. So now we must build out our defensive concept slowly. All new release characters need team's effort to defend. Last one is his ulti, the secret ninjutsu. The mechanism will be the same as Maki. Maximum stack is 4 times. Flying Raijin Jutsu can be used directly, not incurring to any block. This can be used to pick up 4 bow. Okay, fantasy time is over. Let's go back to reality. Why I say a 1 cento is super duper expensive? That is his character's cards. How much will it cost?
OMG, OMG.
There is no diamond option for purchasing his talent card. 1 talent card equal to 450 cash coupons. For fully upgrade him, we need about 180 talent cards, which means equal to 81,000 cash coupons. Our hearing does not fail us. It's 81,000 cash coupons. Let's say we slowly purchase it during double vouchers events. 100 USD equal to 10k vouchers means 8 times. Equal to 800 USD. In total of 900 USD is required to buy and complete to upgrade him. I need to emphasize, only if we purchase it during double vouchers event, means we can buy 2 PS5. This is the reason that I have no desire to discuss about him that much. Because most of us will not willing to spend that much in the game. So a once Rukawa is still the ninja that can be slowly built out. Yes, there is. Here is it. We can accumulate honor crystal fragments during event time. Let's assume the event is continuation event without fail. We can get 1 fragment per day. Means we need 200 fragments to exchange a 1 center profile or 10 talents cards. So we need to grind 200 days for his profile and about 10 years to fully upgrade him. If you enjoy the content, please give me a like and subscribe my channel. Thank you guys.
I will be back.